Hey guys, welcome back to Day on the Untidy Artist. I'll be showing you how to make a fizzy milk bath. I did a milk bath tutorial a few years ago. I've been wanting to do an update on it. I thought it would be really fun to do for Mother's Day and with bridal season coming up. It's a great gift idea. I'll be going over a basic recipe in this tutorial, but I do have two different variations that I'll show you at the end, so make sure to stick around. And then I also have another fun packaging idea, so make sure you stick around till the end. Let's grab some supplies and get started. The star of our milk bath is obviously milk. I'll be using a whole milk powder, which is what I prefer. Milk has lactic acid in it, which is very gently exfoliating to the skin. It also helps to moisturize the skin. We'll be using a couple different salts. The first one is called dendritic salt. This salt has a very fine grain and it actually absorbs twice the amount of oil. So with our fragrance oil, it's going to absorb that really nicely and it will actually retain the scent longer as well. In this first recipe, we'll be using a coarse sea salt. Salt is nice because it's therapeutic, cleansing, and detoxifying, and it also contains minerals that are good for the skin. I'll be using tapioca starch, also called tapioca flour. You could substitute cornstarch for this part. I have some colloidal powder, which is a very finely ground oat powder. You could also blend up your own in the blender, although you probably won't get it this finely ground. I've got some baking soda, and then I've also got some citric acid. And the citric acid and the baking soda, when they hit the water, that's what's going to give us our fizzing action in our fizzy milk bath. So this is kind of the other star of our milk bath. The fragrance oil I'll be using in this is actually a fragrance oil essential oil blend. It's called Lavender and Sage from Nurture Soap. I'll put a link below. And I've got a bowl with a colander. I like to use this to sift all of my dry ingredients together. I've got another glass bowl, a spoon from my kitchen, and a whisk. I've got a spatula. And then I have my trusty kitchen scale. I have already pre-measured all of my ingredients for this recipe. I love this kitchen scale. I'll put a link below. I also have measurements in cups if you'd rather do that listed below as well. And then I'll be putting my milk bath in these cute little milk containers that I got from Michaels. Remember, I've got a fun, different way to package these at the end of the video. Okay, let's get started. So I'm taking 1/2 cup of my dendritic salt and 1/2 cup of my coarse salt. And I'm gonna stir these together. Now we will be using dendritic salt in every single recipe I show you, so in all of the variations. What we will be switching out is the other type of salt. Then I'm going to take 1.2 ounces of my fragrance oil and I'm going to stir that into my salts. So this is the lavender and sage from Nurture Soap. If you like lavender scents, you will love this. It's a classic, fresh, clean lavender with a little bit of sage, rosemary, and thyme in it. So we're just going to stir that really well into our salts, and then I'm taking a pie tin and a piece of parchment paper, and I'm going to put all of that mixture into my little pie tin so that it can dry. And we want it to dry and start to absorb all of the fragrance oil. And I usually let it sit for 1 to 2 hours, and I'm gonna set that aside. And we're going to measure out our whole milk, our colloidal oatmeal, and our tapioca starch. And I'm just gonna use my spoon to press that into my little strainer to get all of the clumps out. And you can see I spilled a whole bunch at the back, so be careful when you're sifting it that you don't do that. And after I've got that mixed together, I'm going to take my citric acid and my baking soda, and I'm going to sift those in. And you can see as I'm sifting this that there are clumps of the baking soda, and that's once again why I like using something to sift it together, because you get a nice unclumpy mixture at the end. And then I'm taking my whisk and I'm just stirring it together really, really well. And you can also take your spatula, scrape the bottom of the bowl to make sure it's all combined together. And once my salts have sat for about 1 to 2 hours, I'm going to take those and mix them into the rest of the dry ingredients. And then I'm going to give it a really good stir. Now, I tried to use my whisk. This bowl was a little bit small for my whisk, so I switched to my spatula. What you want to do when you're mixing this together is use the side of the spatula to really press the mixture together and make sure it's evenly combined. So I'm just pressing it against the side of the bowl to make sure it's all combined together so we have a nice, smooth, textured milk bath. And then I'm going to grab a cookie sheet and another piece of parchment paper, and I'm going to put my mixture onto my cookie sheet and spread it out, and I'm actually going to let it sit for 4 hours to even overnight so it can continue to absorb all the fragrance oil. And then I went ahead and I packaged my milk bath. And with this recipe, I was able to fill 3 of these containers with just over 7 ounces of the mixture each. Okay, so for our next variation, we will be switching out 3 things. Instead of using whole milk, we'll be using buttermilk powder. Instead of the coarse spa salt, we'll be using this pink sea salt. It's beautiful. I love the color and texture that it adds to the milk bath. And then we'll be using a fragrance called Sugar Cookie Crunch. I will put a link for this below. This is my daughter Gabe's absolutely favorite fragrance. It honestly smells like someone just baked sugar cookies, and it's sweet without being overly sweet, and it's just absolutely wonderful. Okay, so first we measured our dendritic salt, our Himalayan salt, and our fragrance oil, and we let it sit for a couple hours while we sift together all of the other dry ingredients. So in this bowl, instead of using the whole milk powder, I've got the buttermilk powder, and then I'm going to mix them together. Give it a nice stir, and like I said, I really loved the just little bit of color and texture that pink Himalayan salt added. So you really can mix these recipes up a lot and play around with textures and different types of salts and milks. Okay, for our last variation, I will be using coconut milk powder. This is great for anyone that's a vegan. It also has a faint smell of coconut, so it's lovely. And then I'll be using pure sea salt for this one. A little tip, if you don't want to use dendritic salt, you could substitute sea salt instead of that, but I do really like the dendritic salt for its ability to absorb the fragrance oil. The fragrance oil we'll be using for the last variation is called First Love. It's from Nurture Soap, and it is my favorite fragrance oil in all of the land. It's a lush duplicate of a perfume that they used to carry called 2543, which is lemongrass and lime and tonka. And tonka is like a spicy cousin to vanilla. And it is truly my favorite perfume ever. I absolutely love it. So because this does contain vanilla in it, any fragrance oil that has vanilla can have the tendency to turn your final product brown. You can see here that it did tint my salts kind of yellow. So keep that in mind when you're formulating your recipes. So I've got all my salts mixed together. They sat for about 2 hours. I've got all of my dry ingredients. And remember, we substituted coconut powder instead of the whole milk powder. And then I'm gonna stir it together. So you can see how simple and easy this is to put together. I think the hardest part is probably waiting for it to dry, in all honesty. And then I decided to add some cute little tags to my milk bath, and I'm just going to tie this around my little container, and we're good to go. These are the same containers I used in my first milk bath tutorial. I will put a link for that below. It does use essential oils, so if you'd rather use essential oils, that might be a good recipe to follow. And now for some different fun ways to package. So I actually bought a package of milk bath from a store that was about this size. It had almost like 2.5 to 3 ounces of the milk bath in it. So it's enough for one bath, and it cost me almost $9. So I thought, we can figure this out. So I have a tutorial coming up in the next couple days of how I made these cute little envelopes. I think these would be so cute for Mother's Day. You could even stack a few together with different fragrances. You could give them to your sister-in-law, sister, friend. I think these would also make a lovely bridal shower gift. They were fast and easy to make, not very expensive, and you end up with this beautifully packaged, very professional looking milk bath. That's it, guys. We're all set. What do you think? I would love to hear if you try this recipe. I'd love to hear what your favorite version is, what types of milks you like to use, and if you prefer a fizzy bath over just a normal creamy milk bath. You can see here the citric acid is just kind of foaming up, giving you this really luxurious, beautiful bath experience. If you enjoyed this tutorial, give it a thumbs up. If you haven't subscribed, please do. It's super helpful. I love hearing from you guys. If you have any comments, questions, thoughts, ideas, let me know in the comments below. If you're feeling social, you can follow me on Instagram. It's Untidy Artist. Thanks again, you guys. You're wonderful, and we'll see you next time.